guys, there is a chat that's been doing the rounds about Nigerian men. South African women, some of the South African women believe that the Nigerian men are the it. If you have a Nigerian man, you have a bag. This brought some kind of a, like some uncomfortability on the South African men, and you know, it was heated on Twitter. Guys, go ahead and watch this next video, then I'll tell you what Twitter had to say regarding this one.
So Mali, I think you're in a very good position to answer the question. Why are Nigerian men loved abroad but neglected at home or taken for granted?
Okay, I'll answer the part of why are Nigerian men loved abroad. So
this thing is South Africa.
Yeah, I'll talk since I'm South African. So in SA, right, we love our Nigerian men.
Our
very own Nigerian men. We're sharing these people. We're sharing these guys with our Nigerian sisters. All right. The reason why we love Nigerian men, firstly, the way they treat us compared to our own South African guys. Mm. You know, a Nigerian man will always make sure that you're good.
Hey.
He will go out of his way to make sure that you are fine. Mm-hmm. Like, whatever I need, if for instance now I'm like, babe, I need to buy hair. I need to make my hair for like 500K. He will not complain. I mean, if he's a correct guy, he has the money. He won't even think twice about giving.
Guy, he has the money.
Yeah, he won't even think twice about giving you the money. Do you understand? Now, if I have to put like a South African guy and I'm like, babe, I need 500K to do my hair, the guy will start complaining first. Like, 500K. Even if he has the money, he will complain. Like, are you going for a wedding? Are you getting married? Even if you're getting married, he'll still complain. Like, you can't spend 500K on your hair. You know, it's the treatment, firstly. Ooh, the treatment is amazing.
What treatment?
Hey, amazing.
For me, I love my men dark.
Ooh.
So, can you see, I'm a light-skinned girl, so I need contrast, you know. It has to be black and yellow, so I love my men very dark, you know. So, that ticks a box, Nigerian men.
Okay.
Nigerian men in bed. Ooh. Do the things that need to be done.
We are more than conquerors.
Guys, that was it, you know. Oh, guys, you don't know what happened. Someone said, where are they elected in that country? Let's deal with that one first. Another one said, our sisters all taking a chance they get to make us look weak to impress their lifestyle funders out there. Another one said, soon Jollofians all feel the heat. It's embarrassing to watch. The Jollofians, they mean the Nigerian guys. In South Africa, they call Nigerians Jollofs. Like, you know how Jollof rice is like, yeah, they call them Jollofs. Yeah, another one went on to say, yo, this is so cringe. She's really embarrassing SA women. And then another one went to say, if Nigerian men were good, that good in bed, Nigerian women would not commit the third highest paternity fraud in the world. Yo, guys, I did not say that. I hope you can actually see who said that. Innovation, they'll get you. Another one went on to say, they don't care, they are motivated by money. The funny thing is that they don't know it's drug money. Yo, guys, I did not say that one as well. Mike Lee, you'll have to answer the Nigerians. Another one went on to say, Nigerians in SA are drug dealers and have a lot of money. Those back in Niger are Odaka and gate men. Yo, it's not for me. Easy Floor said, I live in SA doing great, super legit, and stop generalizing and painting Nigerians bad to compensate for your misery. There are South Africans committing crime all over the world also. Definitely that one, I cannot say it's not true, guys. It's very true. Someone was simply just giving advice to parents that parents If you're a parent and planning to be, please work hard and teach your children that they should not laugh for money and laugh for affection. Teach them about money so that they also know they can have power over money. Yes, guys. Simply said. Honestly, guys, yeah, I think sometimes we overread things. We always like to judge people according to where they come from. I believe a person is a person where, no matter where they come from. There are people that can just be okay if they are Nigerians and be staying in South Africa. And there are those that, it's not like all of them that are into drugs. And then, you know, we also have, and it doesn't mean that, like what the lady said at the end, that they are the 18 bed. Guys, I don't want to believe that. You are who you are. Everyone has been given what they've been given, no matter where you come from. I don't think where, like coming from Nigeria, coming from South Africa, coming from Zimbabwe or anything means like you have the best or something. No, we're all different. Anyway, let me know what you think down in the comments. I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye.